Hello all, myself Dr. Vartya Jagan, working as an associate professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, VBIT. Now, in the last lecture, if you see, we have discussed about a single phase full wave rectifier in midpoint of configuration with resistive load and resistive and inductive load. Now we'll focus on one more load. This is RLE load, where R is the resistance, L is the inductance, E is the battery. You can see here. Okay, and this is a circuit configuration in which the transformer is a secondary center tap transformer, and these are the expected waveforms. So we'll look over this expected waveform, then we'll go for circuit configuration. Just you can see here the first waveform, which is a sinusoidal input waveform. So this kind of waveform we are going to provide at this particular point, or you can say a terminal 1 and 2, and this third terminal. Okay, but I have projected the battery E on the input side. Let me tell you why I am projected in the input side. So now if you see at this particular point, which is theta 1, at this particular point the battery voltage is equal to the Vin, input voltage. Input voltage is sinusoidally varying with respect to sine omega. And during this instant, I will rewrite, I will write here, during this instant, that is from 0 to theta 1, I can write the battery voltage is more when compared to the AC voltage. I can say, right, you can see the waveform and you can tell me easily, right? And from theta 1 to theta 2 during this interval, theta 1 to theta 2, battery voltage less when compared to the input voltage AC. And you will be having one more point here, you can see this point, which is theta 2. Theta 2, when omega t is lying between theta 2 and pi, and during this interval also you can see the battery voltage is more when compared to the AC voltage. So you all know that by the fundamental law of electrical concept, the current flow is possible from higher potential to lower potential. So you can see here we are providing some voltage which may be more than this battery voltage, which may be less than this battery voltage, depending upon the variation, right? And we have seen that from 0 to T1 the battery voltage more, which means the source is at lower potential when compared to the load, which is there. The load consists of the battery. And during this interval, even if you fire the thyristor won't go to conduction state, because this thyristor will carry the current only from source to load. They are unidirectional device, so they won't go to conduction state. So make sure that the alpha, which is the firing angle given to T1 as well as T2, that should be more than theta 1, and it should be less than theta 2. So your firing angle has to vary from theta 1 to theta 2. Theta 1 to theta 2. So this is the firing angle given to thyristor T1. And similarly, if you again see the negative half cycle, again if you see here theta 3 and theta 4. So now between pi 2, theta 3, the battery voltage is more. You can see this portion, the battery voltage is more. Again, from theta 3 to theta 4, the battery voltage is more, you can say. Sorry, the input voltage is more. So I can say this input voltage is more when compared to the battery. And from theta 4 to 2 pi, theta 4 to 2 pi, again the battery voltage is more. That means we need to trigger the thyristor T2 during this negative half cycle only when the theta 2, the firing angle should be between theta 3 and theta 4. You should not be less than theta 3 and it should not be more than theta 4, because before theta 3 and after theta 4, the battery voltage is more. Even if you trigger a thyristor, the thyristor won't go to conduction state. Right. So now, in order to trigger the thyristor T2, our alpha should be lies between theta 3 and theta 4. Okay. So now this is a circuit configuration where the load is connected at the center point of the transformer. Now let us focus on the positive half cycle. Now if you see the positive half cycle, this area during which the thyristor T, it is in forward biased condition from 0 to pi, but if you see the theta, the alpha should be more than theta 1. That is what we have concluded just now. Now here I have given the firing pulse to T1, because T1 it is in forward biased condition, because during positive half cycle, here it will be positive, here it will be negative. And if it is positive, other terminal should be negative. And if it's negative, other terminal should be positive. So T1 anode is connected to positive and the cathode is connected negative to the load. So T1 is in forward biased condition. It will start conducting from omega T equal to alpha onwards. Right. And from this point onward, the output voltage following the input voltage. It is following the input voltage, right? You can see the waveform. Okay, but if you see during the small interval, where you are getting some magnitude, which is a V. Now, if you see during this interval, T1, it is in off condition because we have applied a trigger impulse at this particular point. So T1, it is in off condition. Okay. And T2 is in off condition because it is in reverse bias condition. Anode is connected to negative here. Cathode may be connected to positive to the load. So it is reverse bias condition. So it is also in off condition. So there is no current flow from source to load, because both the devices which are supplying the current from source to load, which are they are in off condition. So you won't get any current. Now the net voltage V0, I can write it as voltage across the resistance plus voltage across the inductance plus voltage across the battery. So since there is no current which is flowing through this load, VR goes to zero, VL goes to zero, and we left with the V0 equal to the battery voltage. That is why you can see here there is a only battery voltage during which both the thyristors are in conduction state. And after this omega T equal to alpha onwards, the output voltage following the input voltage. We don't know up to what extent it will follow, right? So we don't know up to what extent follow. And then now the output voltage will be the summation of battery voltage plus inductor voltage plus resistance voltage, right? Now you can see the equivalent circuit after this omega T equal to pi, omega T equal to alpha. So T1, it is in conduction state. And the current always leaves from positive. Source positive, T1 anode, T1 cathode, and back to the source through the load like this. Okay, so this positive is connected with positive, right? So you are getting some voltage across the load, which is following the input voltage. So I can see that the output voltage, which is a darkened line, is following the dotted line. And the following of input voltage depends upon the value of inductor which is there in the load. Now you can see the, since the inductor, there is an inductance in the load, so during alpha to omega T equal to alpha to pi, the inductor will charge from the supply. It is charging. Whenever it is charging, means it will charge like this, this positive polarity and negative polarity. Now after this omega T equal to pi, the load is subjected to negative voltage, no doubt. And negative voltage means you can see inductor is discharging here. So before discharging the inductor, it has to reverse polarity. The polarity is getting reversed, and the current is flowing through inductor positive, resistance, T1 anode, T1 cathode, and BAB2 battery and inductor negative like this. So now this is the direction of current you can see with red color here, and which is called discharging current. That is why the you can see the discharging portion like this, and here it is completely discharged, right? And during this small interval you can see there is no output current. If there is no output current, I told you that just now V naught equal to VR plus VL plus the battery voltage. So if there is no output current, VR goes to zero, VL goes to zero, and we left with only battery voltage, and V naught will be equal to some battery voltage here that you can see. Okay, that means after the current is exceeding zero, then there is a slight increment in the voltage and is following the battery voltage. And this is what about during positive half cycle. Since T1 it is in conduction state, so the voltage across T1 will be 1 to 2 volts. It is in conduction state and is conducting state up to beta. So you can see up to beta the voltage across thyristor T1 is equal to 1 to 2 volts. Right now we'll move to mode 2. So mode 2 means it is related to omega t equal to pi to 2 pi this portion. Okay, now during this interval, as I told you, negative comes first then positive. So now this polarity will be at negative, this polarity will be at positive terminal. Okay, and load is connected between either it may be connected between 1 and 3 or it may connect between 2 and 3. That depends upon which thyristor is in conduction state. So now if terminal 1 it is in negative condition, negative terminal, terminal 3 should be positive terminal. And if terminal 2 it is connected to positive terminal, terminal 3 should be connected to negative terminal. Right, so you can see here T1 anode is connected to positive, cathode is connected to negative to the load. So T2 it is in forward biased condition. And I told you that T2 can be triggered after this theta 3 and before this theta 4, right? And so that T2 can be triggered at pi plus alpha. So from pi plus alpha onwards, the output voltage following the input voltage like this, right? So now you can see the equivalent circuit this portion. So the current always flows from positive terminal, source positive, T2 anode, T2 cathode, battery, inductor, resistance like this. So again, this terminal is connected to positive. So even though the input supply is getting reversed, you can see the positive voltage across the load, and which is following the input voltage. You can see the input voltage dotted line. Right, you can see this portion. And during this interval from pi plus alpha to 2 pi, the inductor, battery, and the load resistance, which are connected to the source, and out of these, the inductor is an energy storage element, and it will store the energy like this. With this part is positive, and here it is negative. Now, just after this omega t equal to 2 pi, inductor has to discharge its energy. So for discharging, it has to replace its polarity with positive and negative like this. And now, after omega t equal to 2 pi, the inductor will behave like a source, and it will discharge its energy either to the source or to the load resistance. Now, current always leaves from positive terminal. So it is leaving from positive resistance, source, T2 anode, T2 cathode, and battery, and L negative. So this is the direction of current which is flowing through thyristor T2, which is a discharging current. So now you can see there is a discharging. First it will charge, then after it will discharge. It is discharging completely at this particular point, which is called 2 beta. Here you can see, here the current is extinguishes to zero. So the net current flowing through the thyristor 2 goes to zero. So thyristor will become off at this particular point. So turning off matlab the thyristor T2 will goes to in open circuit. Okay, it is replaced by open circuit. Open circuit represents the current is zero, and the same current is flowing through the load as well. So that means just after this B2 beta, there is no output current. If there is no output current, VR goes to zero, VL goes to zero. We left with the battery voltage. So the output voltage equal to the battery voltage. You can see this portion. And again, the positive half cycle, negative half cycle, like this. Okay. And you may have one doubt that what about thyristor T1? So you can see thyristor T1 anode is connected to negative, cathode is connected to positive through the load. So T1, it is in reverse bias condition and it will be in off state. So there is no effect of this thyristor T1 during this negative half cycle since it is in off condition. Okay, now this about RLE load. Now just recall the R load waveforms and RLE load waveforms. Let us compare these two waveforms. So now you can see in case of R load, this is RL load. Okay, you can see the current waveform is like this. Thereafter, it is discharging to zero. You can see the voltage waveform from this point on, the output voltage following the input voltage like this. So during this interval, there is no voltage because there is no current. Thyristor T1 goes to off condition, so you won't get any current. So in case of RL load, we know that V0 equal to VR plus VL, right? Okay, so since there is no current during this interval, VL and VR goes to zero, you will get V0 equal to zero here, right? Similarly, pipe S alpha T2 is triggered and you can get the output voltage following the input voltage like this, and the current is charging, thereafter it is discharge. Again, during this interval, there is no output current, so there is no output voltage because VR and VL goes to zero. Now, if you recall the RLE waveforms, so in case of RLE load, the output voltage is equal to the voltage across resistance, voltage across the inductance, plus voltage across the battery. Right? Again, if you recall, from this point on, the output voltage following the input voltage, which is same as the RL load concept, the current is charging, thereafter it is discharging, no doubt. But during this interval, if you see, there is no current in the load. Even though there is no current, the output voltage having the battery voltage, but which is not there in case of this R load. So the output voltage is having some battery voltage, which is here, right? Because if there is no current, VR goes to zero, VL goes to zero, we left with the V0 equal to E. So you will get some battery voltage here, which is not possible in case of RL load, right? Because there is no battery. Again, at pi plus alpha, T2 is triggered, it is following the input voltage like this. Okay, and the current is lagging the voltage by some angle, charging, thereafter discharging. Here it is completely discharging, and during the small interval where you can see the E, and here there is no output current. If there is no output current, there is no VR term, there is no VL term. We left with battery voltage, you can see the battery voltage. There is a major difference between the RL load and RLE load, right? So let us derive the average output voltage expression. So to derive the average output voltage expression, since this positive half cycle, it is the replica of negative half cycle, so I will consider only positive half cycle since they are symmetrical. So if you see 1 by 2 pi alpha to beta Vm sin omega t minus E into d omega t, right? Sorry, it is not it is 1 by 5 only, because I need to consider only one half cycle, which is of duration pi. So 1 by pi alpha to beta Vm sin omega t minus E into d omega t, and that will give this portion, right? If you don't have any battery, it is just like a inductive load, RL load, and you can see there we wrote it as 1 by pi alpha to beta Vm sin omega t d omega t, right? But there is an effect of battery also here. Now, we just simplify. If you simplify, I can write 1 by pi. I can take Vm sine omega t, which is a minus cos omega t d alpha to beta integration. And we left with this battery. The integration of constant is omega t, and the integration interval from alpha to beta. And you just substitute upper limit or lower limit 1 by pi Vm minus cos upper limit, which is a beta, minus into minus plus cos lower limit alpha. Minus E upper limit minus lower limit. So this is the average output voltage. We rearrange the alpha, cos alpha and cos beta. It will be something like this. Now you can calculate the current which is flowing to the load, and the output current is equal to V naught RMS divided by R, which is 1 by pi Z. Z is the impedance. Vm cos alpha minus cos beta plus E into alpha minus beta. So this is the average output voltage expression. Now you can calculate the RMS output voltage. So to calculate the RMS output voltage, again due to symmetrical waveforms in the output side, now you can rewrite the expression like this. Again, root mean 1 by pi, because I am going to consider only one half cycle, which is of duration 1 by pi, alpha to beta Vm sine omega t minus C whole square into d omega t. It is just like A minus B whole square. I can write Vm square sine square omega t plus C square minus 2E Vm sine omega t. We just separate these terms. It will be alpha to beta 1 by under root pi under root alpha to beta Vm square sine square omega t, this term, plus integration from alpha to beta E square d omega t, this term, minus integration from alpha to beta, and you can write like this. Okay, now we know that I can take Vm square common 1 by under root 2 pi, right? E under root 2 pi, 1 second. So sine square omega t is, you can write it as 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. So instead of this term, you can write 1 minus cos 2 omega 2 by 2. So that is, I have rewritten here, and I have separated those terms. And here I can take constant E square as common, E square alpha to beta d omega t. Here I can take 2 Vm as common, which is a constant, and integration from alpha to beta sine 2 omega, sine omega t d omega t. You just do the integration and substitute the upper and lower limit. I can take Vm square common here, Vm square by 2. And constant integration of constant will be omega t, and the limits are alpha to beta. And here I can take 1 by Vm square, it is there inside this one. So sine square 2 omega t by 2 alpha to beta plus E square integration of constant, which will be omega t alpha to beta, minus 2E Vm integration of sine omega t, which is minus cos omega t. You just substitute those values, and if you substitute those values, you will get the RMS output voltage expression in case of RLE load is this much, which is equal to 1 by under root pi under root Vm square by 2 beta minus alpha minus 1 by 4 Vm square sine 2 beta minus sine 2 alpha plus E square beta minus alpha minus 2 Vm E into cos alpha minus cos beta, right? Even if you substitute here, battery voltage is zero. If you substitute E equals zero, this factor goes to zero, and this factor also goes to zero. We left with this term, and this is the expression for a single phase half wave, single phase full wave rectifier with R L load. Right. So if you know the expression of R L E load, then you can easily remember the expression for R load, expression for R L load. Right. So if you substitute beta equal to pi here, it leads to the expression for resistive load, right? And in order to get more information about this single phase full wave midpoint type configuration with RLE load, please go through this textbook, Power Electronics by P.S. Bimbra, Power Electronics by M.P. Singh and Kanchandani, and Power Electronics by R.H. Rashid, M.H. Rashid. Right. Thank you.